Prince William Sound, at more than 10,000 square miles, is one of Alaska's largest and most diverse marine ecosystems, encompassing the nation's second largest national forest. Within this northern rainforest, centuries of human history lie hidden in the rubble of places like the native community of Chiniga, destroyed by a tsunami during the 1964 Good Friday earthquake, as well as played out mines, old logging sites, abandoned canneries, and ancient fish camps that have fallen victim to changes in resource abundance and natural disasters.
The ecosystem here is just, it's delicate, it's rugged, it's can take care of itself, it can throw everything at you that you can imagine, from the storms to the beauty to the marine life to the sea life to the bird life. It's all here.
In 1989, on the very day that Alaskans paused to mark the 25th anniversary of the Good Friday earthquake, the Exxon Valdez ran aground in Prince William Sound, sending millions of gallons of oil into the water and onto the beaches. Dr. James Balziger is a member of the Exxon Valdez Oil Trustees Council, also known as EVOS.
There was cleanup to start with, get the oil out of the water as much as you could, get it off the beaches as much as it could relatively quickly. Yet we still have oil on beaches, we still have persistent oil. The Trustee Council has been funding work in Prince William Sound to restore the sound to as much as they could what it was like before the spill itself.
Now EVOS faces a new challenge. Efforts to clean up the oil spill are being frustrated by an increasingly large wave of marine debris, particularly consumer and industrial plastics from around the world. Chris Pallister is the head of the Gulf of Alaska Keeper, under contract to the Trustees Council to remove marine debris that is accumulating along the path of the oil spill.
You see all this grass and it's beautiful and green, and then you get out on a beach and you start walking up and down the beach and there's plastic all over the place.
If you take a look at what happened with the Exxon Valdez oil spill, the marine debris flows in the same way through the sound, littering the same beaches that were littered by the oil spill.
So you have all these old beaches from the earthquake, like back in the woods, and that was 64, and there's not a lick of garbage on them, right? Because it was all uplifted. So the plastic has had to be coming since like the 70s, really.
Think of the plastic bottles that you buy. The water bottles are made to be used once. Any of the food bottles are made to be used once. You don't take them back and get them refilled. Sort of a single-use kind of society.
It's absolutely dramatic, the impact on some of the beaches of drifting in plastic.
And you look at Montague Island, and there's 70 miles of coastline out there that have 20 tons of plastic a mile on it. It's staggering.
The next assault on the Trustees Council efforts to restore Prince William Sound has already started.
In March of 2011, the earthquake and tsunami occurred in Japan. Approximately 25 million tons of material were washed out into the sea.
We're going to see a significant amount of it coming in over the next 4 to 6 years. There's a tremendous amount of chemicals and other materials coming in these containers. We have no idea what they are. You dump a drum of chemicals in an estuary, it's spawning habitat, and you're going to kill a lot of wildlife. There's not a whole lot local people can do other than raise a clamor about it and keep picking it up.
It is estimated that removing marine debris from the beaches and estuaries that have already been impacted by the Exxon Valdez oil spill will cost tens of millions of dollars. The real solution, of course, is to ensure that consumer and industrial plastics don't enter the world's oceans to begin with.
Alaska has a lot of beautiful coastline. Southeast, Prince William Sound, Kodiak, the peninsula, and the Bering Sea coast, they're all wonderful and beautiful and pristine. Maybe change your life a little bit to try and prevent these debris from showing up on the shores of Prince William Sound.